Okay, in next lap we will use again the timer, but we will try to force the timer to handle the blinking, the toggling with the LED automatically, without interrupt, without the CPU load. We can try to start new project. In my case, F4, 4011, 401, sorry. LQFP64 pin package. I will open this part. Now, how to do this? I will check first if on the PA5 is some output from the timer. Then I search. I see that there is the ADC, there is possible to have the SPI clock, but there is possible to have the timer 2 channel 1 output. Then I will mark this pin, and I need to configure now timer 2. Then I will not use the timer 10 like before, I use the timer 2, because the timer 2 is internally connected to the pin PA5. I first enable the timer 2 internal clocks. And I need to use the channel 1. Then I will use the channel 1 as a PWM output. Then it's enabled, it's green. Then it's everything from the configuration. Then the timer will be handled automatically, sorry, the pin will be, LED pin will be handled automatically with the timer. We can offload the CPU fully. The clock configuration, we will left this configuration in the default state like before. We only need to remember the 16 MHz for the clocks, for the timers. And we start with the timer configuration. You can see here is more possibilities how to configure the timer, but for the period we will use the same configuration like before. We use the 16,000 for the Pascaler and the 15,999 for the timer. This will be the timer period. But then we need also use the configure the PWM, because this is the output. We use the PWM mode 1 or 2, it's now doesn't matter, but we need select the pulse. The pulse mean where the polarity will change. The pulse is corresponds with the auto reload register, with the maximum, and we know if we want the 50% duty cycle, we need to put there the half of this value. If here this 15,999, here we put the 7,999, the half, to create 50% duty cycle. The rest we can left unchanged. Definitely we don't need any interrupt, we also don't need the DMA, we only check the configuration of this pin, it's the alternating function push-pull, it's okay. And also we have no pull-up and pull-down, and our speed of the GPIO is low. Then we are completely satisfied with this configuration. Okay. Now we can save our project. I name it timer 2. Why not? And I will create the project for the system workbench. Okay, and I can generate my project for system workbench. Now I open the system workbench. System project, I think it's from the last hands-on. Then I will close or delete from my workspace the previous project, and I will import the last project which we have here. Then I want to import the timer. Then I will check all the projects, and I will use only my timer, which I want to have inside my workspace. Okay, here it will be more simpler than before. In main.c, we have here only the timer initialization. The timer initialization is the basic timer initialization. And then we can see we configure the clock source. We configure now also the PWM. And we also configuring the channel. And you can see that the timer configuration is more difficult than, for example, SPI or USART, but it's more advanced peripheral. We don't using any interrupts, only in the MSP. We using the pin. We enabling the pin, and we configure the timer 2 as the alternate function source. In the IT.c, we can find there is no interrupt handling. But how to start this timer? We do this very simply. We type HL, again the tim underscore. This will be underscore x. It's the no, not x, the normal one, sorry. The PWM underscore start. And we can start this without DMA. It's okay. First, we need put the handle. It will be H, I think, timer 2. And then we need to put the parameter for the channel. Then I'm not sure what parameter is this. Then I will go to the declaration. Sorry. And here you can see as the second parameter, we can put channel 1, 2, 3, 4. Then if you remember well from the pinout, we're using the channel 1. Then here I put channel 1. And this start for me the timer. And this timer will automatically toggle with my LED. Then I will try to save all these parts. I will compile my code. And in case that you do everything correctly, as myself, then you will get no error. It seems that everything is still okay, no error. We can set the debug configuration on the AC6. I will select again my debugging source. In my case, it's a ST-Link version 2.1, and I can start debug. When I run the code, you can found that my LED is blinking with the frequency 1 second now. Then it's working. We created very simple example, which creates the duty cycle, the PWM, with 50% duty cycle, and it's not handled with CPU at all. CPU can do something else in the main loop.